great to be back with another video. Recently, I was asked the question, why is it so difficult? We get glimpses of this perfect peace, but only glimpses. Why is it so difficult? Well, let's get into that, because that's the very key question. That's really the most important question. Why do we have such trouble? Why do so few take the very simple, obvious step of freeing themselves from misery? It seems like we can count them on one hand almost. It's amazing. But there is an answer to this, but it's a catch-22. So let's get into this and see if we can really clarify it. The answer is because we don't trust simplicity. Okay? But there again, since we don't trust simplicity, the simple answer that I just gave, we don't trust that either. And so you go into this infinite regression where the only kind of answer we will accept is a complex one, because we trust complexity. So let's start there. Why do we trust complexity? Because we're attempting to accomplish the impossible. We're trying to negate reality, get rid of reality. It's impossible. We can't do it. Very simply, if something's impossible, that's very simple, right? It's impossible. End of story. That's it. But if we say, no, it's not impossible, then where do we go from there? We go into complexity. We say it's very, very difficult. If you want to deny impossibility, negating God, creation, the Creator, Prime Creator Spirit, it's impossible. But if you want to insist it's possible, what's the next step? We say, well, it's not impossible, it's extremely difficult. Meaning it's extremely complex. It'll take billions and billions and billions of years, unbelievable efforts, great, great precision, super complex strategies, etc., etc. And then we say, yeah, and that will actually work. That's what we believe. So we are totally accustomed at this point to believing that complexity and precision equates with success. Therefore, when someone asks, well, how come we don't choose to free ourselves from this impossible, futile quest we're on? And I say, well, it's because we don't trust simplicity. Again, that answer's too simple. The mind will say, oh, no. That's too simple. I don't trust that. I don't believe that answer will equate with success. So we're trapped. It's a terrible trap, really. But in looking at it, at least I believe we can get some wiggle room with it, which is why these videos are being made and why you're watching them, to get a little freedom, little wiggle room, instead of being totally paralyzed. Again, the trap is we don't trust simplicity. Simple and the simple truth is all we have to do is choose a different idea, choose to not try to negate reality. One simple step. That's why those like Muji and Ramana, Punjaji, who invite you in, saying, just take this simple step. That's all they say. Come on in. It's wonderful here. Just an easy, simple step. That's all you have to do. Just let awareness be aware of awareness. Let consciousness marinate in consciousness. Let the object of your awareness be awareness. That's all they're saying. Which is very much the same as saying, choose a different idea, the idea of non-negation. Because awareness cannot be negated. When you choose to be awareness, chooses to be aware of awareness, it's choosing to be aware of that which cannot be negated. You see? So it's really the same thing. Different terminology. And they're saying, just do it. It's easy. No problem. But we don't trust it. Because we have for so long, equated complexity with success. Just take a look at this world we live in our lives, how complex this has become, and how just to survive the enormous complexity and strategies and cooperation and precision that are employed in every aspect of our lives, just to keep us going. So we're terrified of the idea of simplicity. To us, it equates with primitiveness and starvation and death. failure, horrible things. And so we hear say, just take this simple step. We say, no, I want a complex answer. I want a book full of stuff that I can follow. Now, The Course of Miracles came out in 1974, and it's just a massive amount of pages. And at that time, and reading it, for me, as reading, I said, oh, this is great. This is very complex. Great, it's going to equate with success then. And there's so many pages. I just read and read for so many years. I said, this is really going to work because it's so much to it, so complicated, so complex. This is great. But over the years, as I read more and more, gradually I became less and less interested in the complexity. And even found that the vast verbiage there became oppressive. And I said, wow, I want something much simpler than this. I can't stand it anymore. But paradoxically, it's stated in The Course of Miracles that the whole purpose of the Course is to make the Course unnecessary. And in my case, that happened. I can't even read a sentence of it anymore. I just get irritated because it's too complicated. Way too much there at this point. So that shows you that the spiritual path really goes from the trust in the complex to trust in the simple. And it's a weaning process. You cannot really force it, because there's something deep inside of you that doesn't trust simplicity. And for those who do trust it, like Muji, he finally trusted it completely. That's the result of a lot of work of weaning himself away from trusting in complexity, getting to the point where now he trusts in simplicity. It's not easy, because at every step of the way, you keep thinking that the answers you're getting are too simple. And you say, no, I can't trust that. Can't trust it. But if you make the answers too complex, that'll halt your progress, because you'll start trusting in complexity and the answer is totally simple. Simply drop the idea of trying to become prime creator, which necessitates trying to show that you can negate reality. Just drop that idea and exchange it for another idea, the idea of not trying to become prime creator, not trying to negate reality. Just one simple exchange. It's the only way you can be free, or as they say, just awareness, making awareness the object of awareness, and just abiding in the self. That's what Ramana called abiding in the self. The self abiding in the self, which is permanence. There's no negation there in the self. In other words, not taking all this whirl of existence as having any effect on the self at all. Totally simple. So it is a question of trust. And how do you get that trust? Very difficult. There's no magic pill that anybody can take. If there was, it would have been shown and discovered, and everyone would have taken it. But I believe the best way, one of the best ways certainly, is to just be honest about the entire situation. Use honesty and say, this is the situation, this is the trap we really are in. And just see it. Talk about it, define it, recognize it. As simply as possible. If you have to, whatever level of complexity you feel comfortable with, always try to bring it a little more towards simple, simplicity. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. And you will gradually find that the teachings that you used to love because they're so complex, now you just can't stand them. Not that you hate them, but you can't stand it. It irritates you. You say, whoa, this is way too complex. Forget it. Don't want it anymore. I just want something really, really, really simple that resonates with you now. And then you know you've made a tremendous amount of progress. And so part of the trouble of almost nobody willing to take that final step and exchange ideas is that they are perplexed as, how in the world can I really, will that help people? Maybe they may feel like, well, yeah, okay, that's the thing to do. But how is that going to help anybody else? How can I explain it? It's too simple. Nobody will accept it. They'll all reject it. One of the tactics that some of those great teachers use, for instance, Sri Ananda Mahima used this tactic, and she simply would agree with what anybody said. Whatever, if somebody said the moon is made of cheese, she would say, yes, 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 that's right. And she'd say, however, also there is another way of looking at it too. And in this way, you see that it's actually not made of cheese. So both things are true. She always said, whatever you say is true, and then also there's this way also to look at it. So just agree with what anybody says. And this is for people. It reassures people. In other words, makes them feel like that their complexity that they're holding on to, they can still, you know, hold on to it. Don't attack it. But offer up something else that may be a little simpler. You know, like another plate of cookies that's got, you know, a little better icing on it or something. And then they think, well, maybe I'm going to try one of these cookies, maybe, you know. But very difficult. Even the best teachers have very limited success. You know, just look at the great teachers we've had. How many have truly taken that step from their invitation to do so? Very, very few. So you should not lose patience with yourself, with the process. Because we have been habituated to it for so long. But that doesn't mean that it's guaranteed failure, no. You have to see that the habituation to it was part of a necessity. That staying with this for a long time was the strategy that we had to find a way to negate reality. We felt that if we made it complex enough, precise enough, and of a very long duration, that we would finally succeed. So we started out, that was the plan, the strategy. Become extremely habituated to it, work at it for an extraordinary long period of time, and become more and more precise, more and more clever, more and more complex, until we finally find the way to get rid of reality, so then we can build a new house on the demolished house of reality, and we can build a reality of our own. So from the very beginning, that was our strategy. So therefore, we do have this fixation with complexity equaling success. Now, how to unravel that, how to get past that, is the question that we're all struggling with. It's a matter of finally seeing, having the trust, finally trusting, you know what? Complexity doesn't equal success, it equals failure. Reality is not complex. Reality is entirely simple. It says that effects come from causes. Ideas have their effects. Experiencing comes from ideas. That's it. Very, very simple. And yet we've tried to wipe that out and put something else in its place. So the path is difficult. It's difficult for everyone. It goes from complexity to simplicity. Not primitiveness, beyond primitiveness. Okay, primitiveness means trying to function in this world in a basic, simple, primitive manner. We're not talking about that. We're talking about the simplicity of exchanging ideas, one idea for the other. Simplicity of awareness, making awareness the object of its awareness. Just one step, very simple one step, frees you from all misery because casts a blanket of peace across all of existence with no exception. And so we can say that it's very, very possible to make progress, a lot of progress, if you maintain a steady effort in that direction towards simplicity. Keep listening. Keep considering. For instance, today I drove for several hours. I had a CD on with one of Muji's very, very finest invitations, and I just had it on a loop. And this one track looped over and over. I must have listened to it, 50 times or more today. Did it make a difference? Well, I'm sure that it had a positive effect on moving me closer to the ultimate step of simplicity itself. So all these little efforts that you make, whatever efforts you make, they're adding up. They're helping you move away from complexity, from trusting that complexity equals success. It does not. Simplicity, total simplicity equals success. Because success is dropping the attempt to accomplish the impossible. That's the only success that we will find in existence, is dropping it. Dropping the attempt to accomplish impossible. Dropping the attempt to develop some capacity to negate reality. And in its place, we decide not to have any such capacity to negate reality. And then we find that even though everything is still dancing in existence, it has no effect on this feeling that we have. Doesn't touch it. Doesn't even cast a ripple on it. And that's ultimately what we're trying to get. That's what Ramana had. That's what Anandamayi Ma had. You could see that nothing that happened in this world caused the slightest disturbance in them. And their state of mind, their state of spirit was vast tranquility. It was unruffled. That is the goal. And we can get there. All of us will get there eventually. And it's simply a question of transferring your trust from complexity to simplicity and just staying with that process. I know it's extremely frustrating. But the habituation is so deep. It's amazingly deep. And that's the awful truth of the situation, is that we are so habituated. That's why the spiritual path takes quite some time often. That's why it's important to start out early in life. Get a jump on it. Because every single year that you put in is another year that you have that those who don't start don't have. If you put in 50 years on it, and there are those who have not even tried, you've got 50 years, on them. 50 years of tremendous progress. Just imagine if you had not done that. Way to the better. I know that there are those who seem to have done it really quickly, but that is simply, they didn't do it quickly. Okay? Maybe it was dramatic, but the fact is that they had to put in a long, tough path of getting to trust simplicity. They had to. Nobody just goes to sleep and wakes up enlightened if they hadn't gone through this struggle. So, fact is that the day that you put in effort today is one less day that you need to put in effort. And tomorrow will be another less day. And as the years pile up, all those years, you're making it unnecessary for more years in the future. More years addicted to complexity. More years struggling with complexity and precision and frustration. Trying to make complexity work. Trying to get complexity to satisfy us somehow. To bring peace to the world. To get rid of obstructions. To get rid of what we don't like. To force some sort of, happiness on the world. All of that complexity will be going more and more complex and precise. All the high technology has brought in this enormous complexity and precision. And there are people who truly believe in that. They believe in it so strongly, they're pushing it on the entire planet. And there are those who know very for a fact that this is not the way to salvation. And so they're saying, wow, you know, this is bad. This is really bad. I don't want to live in a culture that is addicted to complexity and precision. Because that's a false belief. That's following the idea that the impossible can be accomplished. Cannot. Those who are awakening do not have any interest in investing in a very complex and precise culture. They're much more interested in a very simple, very basic culture with plenty of time to consider truth and to gradually shift our trust towards simplicity. But right now, the world global culture is a tremendous tidal wave of pushing everything in its way, in its wake, towards complexity and precision, and putting our faith in that this is the way. I call that the fourth dimension. It's a shifting into the fourth dimension. The fourth dimension is the ultimate in the belief of complexity and precision. It's where people have the highest commitment to that. And it's a stage of great delay, tremendous delay. The fifth dimension is a place that's very simple, very basic, where people realize that complexity and precision is not the way, and that simplicity is the way. So we have a situation right now globally where there are those who are headed toward the fifth dimension, so to speak, and those who are shifting into a fourth dimensional mindset. So obviously, I would encourage everyone to shift into the fifth dimensional situation. So just a way of speaking right now, but you know, you probably know what I mean. Is that you realize that vast bureaucracy that we have now and global government, all this, it will require unbelievable complexity and precision. They're spying on everybody now with the smartphones. Where are you? Where's everybody? What are they doing? That's more and more precision, more and more complexity. Like we have to spy on every single action that everybody does. And somehow this is going to help us in some way. It's ridiculous. Zero necessity for any of that. And yet it won't be stopped. It's a massive tidal wave of belief and faith and ambition. So we're at the crossroads right now. This is the sign of the cross, the crossroads. Meaning, which way do you go? Do you go horizontal or do you go vertical? Fourth dimension is a horizontal movement. You try to increase your speed horizontally. More complexity, more precision, more speed. Fifth dimension is a vertical ascension, where you drop the idea of complexity, speed, and precision as being useless as far as finding the answer you're looking for. And then you go vertically, which is into simplicity. Exchange ideas, the idea of trying to replace reality with the idea of not trying to face reality, or the Advaita way of make awareness making awareness the object of its awareness. Awareness abiding within awareness. That's the objective as you go vertically into the fifth dimensional mindset. But whatever you do, continue daily to make the best efforts you can, even though it doesn't succeed ultimately for you. You still are going to find yourself much closer along because of your efforts that you made. And you will find yourself trusting simplicity more and more and more. And eventually then you'll accept the invitation, we all will. We'll listen to Muji and he says, come on in, the water's fine. And we'll say, yeah, okay, and we will do it. But until that point, we have to continue to clarify the situation for us so it becomes simpler. Don't try to struggle with speed, precision, and complexity. Try to clarify, meaning see it very simply, like I am doing in this video for you, just presenting very simply, very basic. That's where the truth will be found. You don't need thousands of pages in a book. It's as you start out, you need that because you only trust in complexity. But as you go along, eventually, you will want a simpler explanations. Very simple, very basic. And that'll be music to your ears. You say, ah, that's great. I like that. Wonderful. And the real complex esoteric stuff, you'll say, no. Don't want that anymore. No more. Difficult times right now. We're at the crossroads. All the more reason to continue getting used to simple, basic explanations. That's the most powerful antidote to the times that there is right now. Simple, basic, clear explanations. Choose a new idea. That's it.